What are you working on there, Asifar?
My course outlines.
Course outlines?
Yeah.
Look at me and smile, man. Take your attention off of that.
What course, else can I say?
I just got a nice picture of your pretty little barn out there.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
It goes nice. It really goes nice.
Official sponsor of Canada's Open Big Team.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 300, 370. I got. What's 370 divided by 2? Yeah, Nicola. Hello. How are you? The challenge contest.
Oh, Mrs. M, did you get it?
You've been practicing the car all the way back.
Right, what would you like to say?
One from the school.
He's your winner. There's no question about that. The question is now silver medal, bronze medal, and fourth place.
No way.
Why not?
Why not?
Her voice is a little flatter than the others and it makes her more conscious of it.
Me? You're very
well. She's sharp. She's flat, but I'm not.
You're perfect. Okay, then you can sing.
Why? I got into the choir.
Coming up, we have a little bit for everybody.
Choir?
I know.
Karen.
Welch choir?
No, it was just a choir. Because there was this thing for the Grand Council, and so we went to the school. We had to go for it. I wanted to go for a choir to sing in it.
Very good. What's that you were working on there?
It's a puzzle book.
Mm.
Thank you.
needed a 10 cents piece.
Could have sold out fences and fence.
We did. Mummy only got me pens, and even those pens are
Melt all down the bearded. So blow out all the candles, blow out them, please.
Now. There's two more left.
Quick,
all the ice cream's gonna melt.
All
the
green wax on it. You need a big flip, put it down.
There you are.
A waxy ice cream.
Would you like to look after this for us, Shauna, before it melts? You can put it back in the freezer or whatever.
Right.
And we can save it for next year now. Or it's a freezer just so it hardens again.
Does anybody want more tea?
Dave will have another cup of tea, and that's it.
I hate to inform you, I wasn't actually born on the 28th.
Have we made a dreadful mistake?
I was born on the 29th. I expect this to happen again, right?
Don't hold your breath.
Well, 29th of February.
My mother says I was twins. So there you are.
You ought to know.
Look at that, Demi. Sarah, look at the TV. Oh, that's what she's looking at. That's that baby in there.
Oh, she's looking at the camera.
What's he saying, Sarah? You're really serious.
What's that? Amy trying to get any pictures. She's out of it. You have to
lure her. Oh, there you are, Amy.
There's her head
skin.
And her bruises and all.
Yeah.
Oops.
There. And here's Gracie peeking up over the coffee table.
Oops.
Where's your nose, Sarah? Where's your nose?
No, Amy, you're too close.
Come back
up.
Here, honey.
You'll be too close. We'll
where's,
to get you.
Where's Sarah's nose?
Gone?
Put your hand on your nose.
Amy, you're blocking everybody.
There, that's right. Where's mommy?
Sit back a bit and get you in better, Amy. Go back a little bit next to mommy.
Right back here. That's better. Sarah, where is Amy's nose? Where is Amy's nose? Good.
Gone?
Right there, right there. There's Amy's nose. She's admiring yourself. Gracie has one little fleck of paint on her nose to show what she was helping Mommy do yesterday. Are you a clown?
Oops.
Put your little smile up above the
sounds
counter.
Sounds like a nanny go up there in the corner. Amy, that's bad, bad, bad for you. You don't know what it does, but it looks bad. You don't have problems.
That's better. Monkey, there's a monkey by the shelf.
Good
Gracie, you come over here and sit down. Gracie, sit down right here. You want to sing Hosanna?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Okay, so you come sing.
Lift up his name.
She can't sing.
With her spirit praise, be exalted, O Lord my God. Hosanna in the highest. You sing, Sarah. Hosanna. Hosanna, Hosanna to the King of Kings. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the King of Kings. Gracie, come stand over there, please. Sit. Or sit there on the edge of the fireplace. Gracie, Amy, you're proud and Sarah, right? Okay, but I don't want you to see
close.
Come on.
Sarah. You told you were moving pictures there.
Sarah,
move down. Amy, you're big enough. Come down a little further. So that Sarah can get it
down this way. Gracie?
Can I go over and sing clapping after this one?
Say. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the King of Kings.
Yeah.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the King of Kings.
Gracie, you just sing that so nicely.
Yeah, what do you sing, Gracie?
You're just in the monkey mood. You expecting us to clap now? Hi! Very nice. Yeah. You have to come and sing at Talent Night at the camp.
Head and shoulders, knees and toes. Amy, you do the actions. Head and shoulders, knees and toes, knees and toes, knees and toes. Head and shoulders, knees and toes. Clap your hands and praise. She all
Once upon a time, there lived a woman. She called all the Christians, and she gave them 1, 4, 8, 12 suitcases to each one of them, and she gave them a hot stewing pot of macaroni. Thank you.
Tom the paper son
went stole the pig and away he ran. And Tom was beat down the street.
Very nice.
Oh, very good.
She's bowing. Gracie told some nice poetry, didn't she?
I said a nice one too.
Tom went down the street.
And Tom
That's very nice, Gracie. Mm-hmm. You told a nice poem.
Sarah said hers before.
Sarah, you got a poem? Mm-hmm. What about Tucker? Do you have a poem, Tucker?
Tucker, raise your head and say what you have to say.
Tucker, Tucker, Tucker! There you go. Short and sweet. I didn't have to pinch you, though, did I?
Tuck-tucks. Tuck-tucks.
Lizzie, go to one side and stand there and just pat her. Pat the kitty, honey. You want to pet the kitty on? You know, that's a windy day. You can hear the wind blowing down the chimney.
I think it's going to rain outside. We'll check.
That's nice, Casey.
Tucker!
Okay, you can turn off now. Let's hear it.
You turn off when he's ready.
In Daddy's car. So when he goes to work, he has a surprise sitting on the seat next to him.
But he doesn't look at it, but first what he does, he doesn't look at it, and he puts it underneath something, and he doesn't see it.
There. Sleepy babes.
He doesn't look at it. Okay.
Here
comes the horsey on the tree.
Some variation.
Here comes the hurricane.
Book.
Hello, Norman.
Hello.
Did you get a good shot of this one?
I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on vales and hills. When all at once.
Thank you.
You can move, it's a video.
It's a video. I'm waiting for a picture.
Yeah, you can move around.
Oh,
you know we live fairly near you. We live in Eastern Ontario.
No, I've got a few here. That's all. Yes.
Tell us all about it. Are you having a nice time at camp?
Lovely.
What are you doing?
Lots of things.
Like?
Activities.
Activities? What are activities?
Swimming.
Yeah.
Canoeing.
Yeah.
Kayaking.
Yeah.
Kneeboarding.
Kneeboarding? What's that?
I don't know.
Alright, me and Christina are going ahead.
Lots of things.
Very good. Hi there, buddy. Hi there, buddy.
Could I have this lovely couple together, please, just for a little photo opportunity here?
Yeah.
Me too, Jim. good, then we better get it there for 9 a.m.
Grandma, keep on moving. You can still move it sometimes. It's kind of dirty.
I want to go there first.
I'm going to go to Disney with that shit.
Are there any questions? Go!
Come on, Joe.
That's not a question.
Yeah, are the stations all manned, Raylene?
I'm going to.
Okay, well, I can man one.
Come on,
Aaron. Come on.
Till it's all over, and then we'll go get some candy.
Yeah. Two pennies.
Take it out.
Okay, come back.
Good stuff. Okay, come over here. Let's go.
Thank you.
Very good shot.
Are you going for seconds though?
Yeah, Ray.
No, I'm not in the seconds yet.
Rich is there, partner.
What can you buy more than one?
Yeah. Well, you're going to.
Come on, baby.
Well, you have to return them to me. What do you want? Who gave me these three pennies? Okay, you can go get your M&M's. You want an M&M?
A raisin man.
Huh?
Well, I'm doing seconds right now.
Okay. 3 cents for the M&M.
3 cents, I'll give you something, right, Chrissy.
I need a Snickers for Jillian.
Hey, Catherine, 3 cents. You got something?
Oh,
okay. What do you got? Okay, Mitch, what you give me there, buddy? One penny? No, you gave me that. You gave me 2 pennies.
Bye.
I have 4 more pennies.
What's that? Okay, there you go. You got it, buddy.
What?
Come just up to the Christmas and I'll give you all my
purple. Daddy?
Oh, wow.
It's that thing off me.
Okay, so 3 pennies for those.
No, be careful of that Westerner there.
And 2 for these.
Look, Rich.
3 pennies.
Be careful of that Westerner there.
3 pennies. 2 things.
3 pennies.
All right. How many times you been up here?
One!
Oh, yeah, you're okay.
Three for Snickers. Is that
what
I'm
at?
That's
right. Oh, those guys are too hot.
No, Aaron. No, Khaki's got one, Aaron.
Okay, watch.
I did clogging
and I got...
Okay, come on, you guys just
spin him.
Come here.
Randy? Dave's been doing a very good job of justice recently.
I drew
one,
Eric!
Four
seconds! I'm gonna shoot that
one. Oh, you owe us 3 cents, though.
No,
Joy, you should have come to the dancing. It was so much fun.
Ping Pong Ball, and it's a really, really fun song. So, Jill's gonna explain how it goes. Okay, the words are,
I've got a head like a ping pong ball. I've got a head like a ping pong ball. I've got a head like a ping pong ball. Ping, like a ping pong ball. Ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong ball. Ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong ball. Ping. Ping, 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 pong. I've got a head like a pong ping ball. Okay, and it goes on like that. So, I want to hear all your voices really, really, really loud.
Ready?
All right? So, I've got a head like a ping pong ball. I've got a head like a ping pong ball. I've got a head like a ping pong ball. Ping, like a ping pong ball. Ping pong, 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 ping pong,
ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong.
It's a repeating song, so I'll sing a verse and you repeat after me, okay? So,
and the green grass grew all around, all around, the green grass grew all around.
That's the part we sing together.
Hey.
Sing that together, okay? Okay, and now, on that grass,
on that grass,
there was a hole.
There was a hole.
Just a prettiest little hole.
Just a prettiest little hole.
That you ever didn't see.
That you ever didn't see.
And the holes in the ground, and the green grass grew all around, all around, the green grass grew all around. Now in that hole,
now in that hole,
there was a root.
There was a root.
Just a prettiest little root.
Just a prettiest little root.
Time and pick your own opponent And but you have to mark it on the sheet out there where you signed up. Otherwise, it could get confusing. That was that part of it. You can't sign up more than once. Some people have been signing up twice, and when I asked them why, they said that they figured if they lost, then they could just play again. You can't do that. Oh, the rules, in case anybody doesn't know. If it's a ringer, you get three. If it's touching the post, you get two. And if it's within a shoe width, you get one. And we have an optional time limit in an attempt to passivate certain people. We'd like you to keep it to an hour, but if you can't do that and it bothers you that you haven't got 21 points, then you can take a mutually agreed time, preferably after dark, to finish the game. Please always put the shoes away in the sports equipment complex and replace the plastic pipes when you're done. And oh, we're ready to play. We have four stakes in the ground now.
Come on! one out for a while.
Okay.
And do half and half.
Can you just throw my trick rope in then? Can you get down?
Your what?
I have a knee board rope.
Down there?
Yeah. Rope up and down last night.
On the dock?
No, it's up in the woods there.
Okay, yeah. Well, I don't know if we can do it. Okay.
Are you filming, Charles?
Mm-hmm. Get in the yacht out there. And stop.
Are you spotting for me?
No, I'm my friend.
Kelly, who's my spotter? Thank you.
Who's Christina?
She's Shauna's friend, yeah.
She's moving up to Vancouver.
I'm sorry?
She's moving up to Vancouver.
Uh huh.
Did you make a
In our weakness, he is strong.
Thank you. Responding to God in Joshua 2 and Joshua 3 and 4 that we focused on yesterday, and the whole principle of submission and submission to the Lord's authority. I'm dying to see what Ruth is going to do tomorrow, because if you've looked ahead, Joshua chapter 5 is about circumcision. To be honest with you this morning, I feel a little nervous about what I want to speak with you about. We can't skip over Joshua 5. It's right here in front of us. And I don't know how comfortable you are with me yet. And this is a sensitive passage in the sense of its foundation and the truth to which it's speaking and the undergirding principle. And I'm going to ask you to think, instead of superficially, about the ritual of circumcision. I'm going to attempt, under the Lord's leadership, for us to think a little bit more deeply about this issue. How many of you have ever heard in your church a sermon on circumcision? What kind of church do you go to? But I'm serious. Here we are. We're in Joshua chapter 5, and that's exactly what this is about. And it's this passage is based upon another passage, Genesis 17, that we'll look at in a few minutes. And that's what's before us. So we are going to trust the Holy Spirit of God to lead us into a deeper understanding of what was in the mind of God when he introduced the ritual of circumcision to the Jewish people. That's where we're at. Let's start by just thinking for a moment about the concept of access. The concept of access. Access has to do with getting close to someone or getting into some place. Keys give us access into rooms and homes and locked automobiles. Things like trust, welcome, friendship, openness, transparency give us access into people, into their lives, into their hearts. And I believe that for every person in this room, there are two competitive urges that we experience throughout the course of our lives. The first is the urge to be known. It is the urge to be known and to relate closely with someone or someones. And the source of that urge is the fact that our loving God created us to be in relationship with himself and with one another. And so we have that urge from creation.
Back, it's the I'm Birthday Song Ballad by Kat. I head back.
Yay!
Is she ready to do it? Well, let's start off the evening and then we have a little song.
That you want.
last year. Do you remember, Jen?
Well, I remember it.
Do you remember?
I remember.
Do you remember?
I do.
All right.
But yeah. Are they ready for it?
I don't know. Are you guys ready?
Yeah!
Yes!
Well, the number one reason, or the number one saying at family camp last year was, is that Don Johnson?
No, I think it's Mr. Henry!
All right. Yeah. That was the number one saying last year. Okay, so now we're going to start off in this year, this family camp we're talking about, the top 10 reasons why everyone should get up at 3 a.m.
And we've got the number 10 reason, the stars at night are big and bright, deep in the heart of Iowa.
Number 9, shuffleboard court is unoccupied.
Number 8, you can be early for breakfast.
Number 7, you can be even earlier for lunch.
Number 6, what we want is more punctuality.
Number 5, no rush for the showers.
Number 4, dance quiet.
I know. Don't see that very often, but that's very important. Number 3, Phil is asleep.
That is true, yes.
And number 2, I know this is most important to you young people. There is no lineup for Tuck.
And the number 1 reason why everyone should get up at 3 o'clock in the morning is that there's lots of extra parking at the beach.
But I tell you, these top 10 reasons wouldn't be good if we were all up at 3 a.m. So if we were all up at 3 a.m., there wouldn't be lots of extra parking at the beach, and Dan would definitely not be quiet.
There would be a lineup for Tuck,
and there would be a rush for the showers. We definitely wouldn't all be punctual because there'd be no coffee.
Never mind. I was late, I was headed in that.
Like, you're not gonna watch me pull my pants. About an old lady that my grandfather introduced to me when I was about 3 years old. She's a beautiful lady drifting down to the sea. We've been out for a row, the St. Lawrence and me. She's dressed in garments of granite and pine, and though she's been mistreated, she still suits me fine. She's always the river for me.
From Long Point on Wolf Island to Newfoundland's windward coast, she's the river that I dream of, the one I love the most. And every time I listen to hear the breakers roar, yes, every time I hear her, each time she stirs me more.
As I'm dragging my skiff up onto the beach, and the pebbles are grating beneath my feet, I know I am hers and that she is mine. This river and I been around a long time. She's always a river for me.
From Long Point on Wolf Island to Newfoundland's windward coast, she's a river that I dream of, the one I love the most. And every time I leave her to head on up the shore, yes, every time I leave her, each time I miss her more.
As she threads her passage through island and shoal, you can see where we all have taken our toll. When I was a lad, the river ran clean. The effects of our pollution were yet to be seen. Yet she's still the river for me.
From Long Point on Wolf Island to Newfoundland's windward coast, you're the river that I dream of, the one I love the most. And every time I see you in moonlight by the shore, yes, every time I see you, each time I love you more.
Tammy and Tommy. Hello, Tammy and Tommy.
How's your damn head? We're so pleased to be here. You know, we were at your barbecue the other night.
Yes.
We had such a good time. We thought we'd just come back.
Oh, that's great.
So please take them away. They don't really need to come in now. But I'll tell you, there's one fella we'd like to come in. Is that good looking fella Phil here?
Oh.
We saw him outside.
I saw him. Isn't that him in the back?
We used to one of our hit songs from a few years ago and kind of rewrote it a bit because we just sing so much of this kind of year. I don't know, 39 years, you know? We just sing it for you. It all helped us.
the teachers getting after that as a...
Thank you. my land. My land is my hunt.
My gun, my trigger, my bullet, my coon.
That's my fence. My land is my coon.
You got a thick skull. I shot this thing. It's my coon.
Okay, I hoof for it. I hoof you for it. I hoof you, and you hoof me. First one contest, loses the raccoon.
Okay.
I demonstrate, I go first.
Fingers from here, but like there was no record on that. They were all, don't play cards with this man. He's gonna, they're gone. Are you gonna play another one? Want another chair?
Thank you.
panel is Claudia Schaefer. And would you like to say a word to the audience, please?
I'm just going to show you how to apply your makeup so you look like a supermodel.
Here's a product from Revlon. It's spring water makeup. Claudia will tell you how to put it on.
Perfect.